ladies and gentlemen. Here we are at the start of day two. Cloud, sunshine, a bit of breeze, no rain forecast for today. Going to head towards Ranworth. See what the situation is like is there. And then I'm not sure what, maybe up the Ant, maybe Potterheim. It's supposed to be windy later today and tomorrow. So I might head into Herbert Winter's yard for a bit of shelter. When I say windy, it's only going to be up to like 20 miles an hour. I don't want to be banging against the side by the wind, the front swinging round. Can't really be bothered to put the mud wave down, to be honest. I have noticed when I watched the footage from yesterday that I did say "um" a lot, which today I'm going to try not to do. So it's just coming up for 9 o'clock. The clouds have now come over. It was bright blue sky when I woke up this morning. It's supposed to be sunshine and clouds for about 10, 11, and then it's just supposed to be clouds for the rest of the day. And then tomorrow the rain comes back. I've noticed that when I was in Morning Ferry Marina's yard last night, a lot of the people that turned up for their boats yesterday actually stayed in the yard. I think there must have been about 6 boats that just stayed in their yard overnight and didn't bother venturing out anywhere. Which is fine, that's their own thing, that's what they want to do. But it is a bit of a waste of the day's holiday, isn't it, really? But each to their own, everyone has their own personal journey plan, I suppose you want to call it. But yeah, we'll see what today brings. Play it by ear, go with the flow, that's what all of those are all about, isn't it? So I'll catch you later on.
So we're going to take the compulsory trip towards the church that everyone has to do when they go to Ranworth. However, I do very much doubt it will be open. Stop saying with everything that's going on. It's quite busy already at Ranworth. I think, well, coming into Malthouse Broad, I passed about 7 or 8 boats that were coming out. The island had quite a few boats on it as well. But managed to squeeze in on the side of the moorings at Ranworth Stave. Four boats in front of me, were trying to moor along the front. I don't think they realised that there was space along the side, so a bit naughty of me, I just overtook them all and went down the side, and then three of them decided to follow me, so apologies if I jumped the queue, but it's about awareness, and I wasn't prepared to hang around just bobbing along waiting for people to moor up. To think of it, I don't even know we had a go in church at all. One, I don't know whether it'll be open for visitors, and two, if it was, I haven't got a mask on me. Very overgrown. Some nettles and thorns. Give the council a ring, get them out there. Not on a Sunday, obviously. I think I'll walk along the road on the way back. Seem to be anyone up there.
So ladies and gents, the situation is, everywhere is busy. St Bennet's, London Bridge. London Bridge is like 12 day boats moored up there. Take a look at the room. out here was chock a block. So the next, I'm not even going to bother going up to Neaton's End. No point. Not now, anyway. So the next stop will probably be Stalham. At least I'll know I'll be able to get in their boatyard, plug into electric, get water in the morning as well, and pop into Stalham to get something for dinner. I'll cook on board again like last night for cheeky takeaway. River Ann is very slow this afternoon. There's a lot of boats going down it and a lot of them doing less than the speed limit. And as everyone knows, River Ann is very, very difficult to overtake on. And with the wind as well, having to keep going on and off the throttle because someone can't do the speed limit, it's quite frustrating. Just cut past our hill, like I say, it was chock-a-block. Those people out on the green in front of the house as well. Not one single space for any size boats, unfortunately. I'm now in a procession of five boats, four out of five, one behind me. Trying to fight against the tide and the wind and do less than the speed limit. They're not good combinations. I'm trying to find a place at the front, well, in front of me, that can, so you guys can look out the front when I'm going along, but I've yet to find something to put you on yet. So you can see what's going on out the front. Maybe that's a project for this afternoon. So you get some outside footage tomorrow from the front. Rather than seeing me and what's going on behind all the time. I would say the River Ramp was more of a meandering river. It's quite laid back, slow. I mean, a lot of that's to do with how narrow it is, but everyone just seems to go really slowly along it, even on the wider parts. I'm definitely doing less than 4 miles an hour. Something I haven't noticed a lot though this year, and I don't know if it's because there's a lot of new people coming up here, not people that come up regularly or been up before but previous years, but you go past them and they just completely blank you. And so now I've just decided that I'll just wave when someone waves at me. Why do you think it's stupid? But anyway, update you further once we get to wherever we're going to go. Like I said, probably it's going to be Stalham. There'll be plenty of room in their yard. So we'll go from there.
Coming through Erstead now. Looks like there might be space on the stave, but there's not really much at Erstead. It's a lovely place, but there's not many places to go. There's a bit of a trek to need to search from here, which I believe you can get to. but no, I'm going to carry on going down the river. Still in procession, still five of us. Certainly treat this broad as a free-for-all, which is very naughty. There is still a speed limit of 5 miles an hour. Sailing boats out here today, with it being a Sunday and there's quite a breeze out there, but you can only see 1, 2, 3, 4 with actual sails up.
Yard now. Not sure which pace I'm going to go in yet though. Depends if any have got restrictions in, I guess. Loads of room, that's what I thought there would be. Right then, catch you all later.
Good evening everyone, here we are in Richardson's yard. Originally came into Kingfisher Quay, but as I tied up, plugged my electric in, had to sit down, noticed a big sign on the post behind me saying no overnight mooring on Sunday evenings. I just helped a Brinks Serenade boat in as well and gave them the good news that we're going to have to move. So we'll come round to, what's this, Swan Quay. Most people probably recognise it. Frequent visitors. Let's go for a little wander. Quite a few non-Richardson's boats in this basin. There's a few Richardson's as well. So they're going to be heading home tomorrow. Looks like Broadland Galaxy's having some work done on it. Got the door up on there. Here we have Siesta, which is the same as my Brinks Duet. Exactly the same. If not all of these Richardson's boats moored here are for sale. I know Quest definitely is. Fairly good shape that. That one moored on sideways over there, that's been sold. It's private people who are not living on it, but they were staying on it the other day. But as you can see, a lot of the Richardson badging has been taken off of these boats. All it is just their name and the registration numbers. Has been left open. Be a nice buy for somebody. San Marino. Hired this boat back in about 2008. Sad to see her up for sale. This must be a major gem. Yep, had major gem 2 a few years ago as well. I genuinely believe these are all for sale. light on. Monarch. I've seen Monarch 2 on Rippers. That one's obviously not for sale at the moment. I think these are X Connoisseur cruisers that have just been left, which are also for sale, I believe. Amazing sky again tonight. On the other side of Merlin now, and as you can see, the boats I've just walked past around the other side have had all their Richardson's logo taken off the front of them. So I guess that means they're officially no longer on hire. Grab yourself a bargain, people. You know these boats can be well maintained over the years. Yes, they would have had a few bumps and scuffs and stuff like that, but that's only cosmetic. If I had the money, it's definitely something I'd be doing. Here we have the local wildfowl. Settling down for the night. That's where I was moored earlier, before I read the sign. Come back to that place there. Didn't particularly want to be moving the boat at 7 o'clock in the morning around the other side, so it's probably just best to get it over and done with today. I haven't got to worry about it. We'll be up early anyway, but don't really want to be moving the boat that early. Got to give it to Richardson's for their organisation. Barriers, hand sanitizer, plenty of warning about the spread of corona. A lot of duck and geese along here, more than I've ever seen. Not more around this side now. See your boats, which has got no window, so they're for sale. The bright gem, tropical gem, Ibiza, didn't see that one. I'm not sure if it's feeding time or story time. Everywhere. So that pretty much wraps up day two. It's starting to get a bit dark now, so it's difficult to film anything, so I've got to head back to the boat. Here she is, all on her own. The wind's dropped though, because it was banging against the side earlier when I came in. I'm bothered putting the mud weight down, no point. But yes, see you all again tomorrow.